William Hill sponsors Joshua versus Brazil on Sky Sports Box Office.
Radio Raheem here with Glenn McCrory. You are at ringside for so many great events here, especially at the O2. We've got another Anthony Joshua fight on the card. What do you think of this matchup, and how do you think Dominic Brazil can fare Saturday night?
I think it's a very good matchup because it's just the beginning of a journey for Anthony Joshua. I don't think he himself even feels he's number one heavyweight in the world just yet, but he's got a good weight to go, and I think he's enjoying it. This is another step on the way. He was fast-tracked into the IBF title. I thought it turned out to be a good move. Now they can, you know, and it will be quick as well, but over the next year or so, he can fight different fighters, gain experience against different styles, because that's very important. You know, he's still very inexperienced. You know, he's not long out the amateurs, just 16 fights, going along great, but this is an opponent that brings size into the equation, and he's never really had to deal with that yet. So I think this is going to be a good test.
This is a situation in which you think Dominic Brazil can, if not win, at least show us something that we haven't seen from Anthony Joshua?
Most definitely, because, you know, he comes in, he knows exactly what he has to do. You know, he's not coming like Charles Martin, kidding himself. He knows that it's going to be a tough fight. He knows it's going to be a physical fight. He knows there's a chance he's going to get hurt. But he's a physical guy. You know, he's played American football. You know, he's been hit, and he's been hit hard. So I think, you know, we'll be looking to see him use that height, use that size, try and, you know, make it a bit rough in there. If I was training him, I'd want him to get close, use your physical size, use your strength, and see what Joshua's got in the late rounds in the fight.
You know, there's a couple of other heavyweight bouts happening on this weekend and then a couple of weeks after that. We'll visit this rematch with Tyson Fury and Vladimir Klitschko. Do you see that second fight going any different than the first? And how do you think Klitschko will match up mentally this time against Fury?
Well, I think it always looked a tough fight for Fury initially, but if Fury can win abroad, he can win in Klitschko's backyard, then he can win in Manchester. And, you know, that fight, as it gets closer, the pressures will become more and more on Klitschko. He's come out with a different sort of attitude, it seems, for this fight. But, you know, you just got to look at Vladimir through his whole career. He's a very cautious fighter. And I think the one person he's afraid of is somebody who's crazy, and he thinks Tyson Fury's crazy. So then he just can't evaluate Fury properly like he likes to do. Remember, he's a doctor, he's a professor, he speaks all his language. He can't break Fury down because you never know what's going to happen next. So I think over the next 2 weeks, Fury, bit by bit, will get inside his head again, and he'll just revert to type. It'll be a careful performance, and I think Fury can do it again.
This Saturday night, we're going to have two heavyweight titles on the line, both being aired on Showtime, and the second fight will be Deontay Wilder and Chris Areola. Now, in both of these matchups, it appears that the champion is coming in as a heavy favorite. Assuming that they were both to win their fights, do you think it's a good time for them to face each other, Deontay and Joshua?
I'm not sure the Joshua camp will really be looking for Deontay quite yet. I think they still feel like, you know, they're in the learning process, and I think that's exactly right. I think Anthony thinks that himself, but I think it won't be long. I know he's got a mandatory against Joseph Parker. He'll be looking to have that probably early next year, and then I think about another 12 months will be the time when Joshua, you know, who's only 26, that's the time when he'll be looking to be in the big super fights. And so there's plenty of time. There's no rush when you're 26. You're Olympic champion. You know, he needs opponents like Dominic Brazil. He needs to learn the game.
You know, we'll never probably get a heavyweight unification tournament, but if we were, for the current belt holders right now, who do you think would win that tournament? Who's the best?
For me, I think over the next 12 months, we'll find out who's the best, and the best will be Anthony Joshua. And I think he's going to take us on a wonderful journey like we had with Lennox Lewis. I was here 27 years ago at the beginning of when I started Sky, on the beginning of Lennox's journey. And I was a part of it for a little while. And I think it's going to be something like that. I think, you know, we could be in for a decade of great, great fights featuring Anthony Joshua.
Well, here's to hoping that we're embarking on another golden era in the heavyweight championship division. Radio Raheem with Glenn McCrory. Such a pleasure to talk to you. Always great to get your analysis. We'll see you Saturday night at the O2 Arena.
William Hill sponsors Joshua versus Brazil on Sky Sports Box Office.